Stated Clearly presents... Did dinosaurs ever live alongside humans? Before digging in, it's probably worth noting that for the same reason that scientists consider humans to be mammals, they also consider birds to be dinosaurs. Birds are currently placed within the dinosaur clade. With this in mind, the answer to our question is yes. Just look around outside and you'll probably spot a dinosaur in less than a minute. That said, here we want to know about the big ones. Dinosaurs like T-Rex, Triceratops, and Stegosaurus. We even want to know about some of their non-dinosaur comrades, creatures like pterosaurs and plesiosaurs. In the 1933 film King Kong, an island is found filled with dinosaurs and other magnificent beasts. The movie, of course, was just fiction, but today there are enthusiasts who claim that dinosaurs are either still alive in remote regions of the world, or that they recently went extinct and that ancient people once lived alongside them. Could this really be? Well, according to what we know about biology and evolution, it is technically possible. Coelacanths and crocodiles, for example, have been around since the time of the dinosaurs, and modern forms do still exist. Coelacanths were even thought to have died out with the dinosaurs until a living population was recently found. Even though it may be possible, as of now, there is no solid scientific evidence that dinosaurs ever lived at the same time as humans. Science can be described as the collection and documentation of observable facts, and an ongoing discussion about how those facts can be best linked together into explanations. This means that if you want to make a scientific claim, first, you need evidence. What kinds of evidence would qualify? Well, photos and eyewitness accounts might help get individual researchers interested, but these things are not convincing to the scientific community at large. Photographs are just too easily faked, and eyewitness accounts are often well-meaning but inaccurate. If you really want to be convincing, what you would want to find are things like human and dinosaur bones fossilized in the same rock layer. Better yet, a fresh dinosaur carcass, though please don't kill a dinosaur if you ever find one. They're very rare. Best of all, capturing a live specimen. Unfortunately, so far, all claims of human and dinosaur fossils alongside each other have either proven to be hoaxes or misinterpretations. The same is true of rotting corpses thought to belong to dinosaurs or plesiosaurs. The one on the left here is actually a beached killer whale. On the right here is a basking shark with its gills and jaws rotted away. The same is true of ancient human artwork claimed to be depictions of dinosaurs. So far as we know, with the exception of birds, the only place to find a dinosaur is in the fossil record. So, what does the fossil record tell us? As volcanoes form mountains that erode into dust, and as ecosystems grow and then die, layers of sediment slowly build up on the face of the Earth, eventually becoming sedimentary rock. As a result of this normally slow sediment buildup, different sets of rock layers represent different time periods in Earth's history. The further down you go, the further back in history you travel. Plants and animals that die and are buried in these sediments are sometimes preserved as fossils. Using multiple lines of evidence, chemical composition, radiometric dating, the orientation of magnetic particles, and the presence of certain well-studied fossils, scientists have been able to create geological maps showing which layers of rock in one region or continent correlate with specific layers of rock in other regions or continents. These maps now allow us to look at fossils all around the globe and study the history of life in chronological order. In these studies, dinosaurs appear to have evolved from an early group of reptiles called archosaurs. This happened during an ancient time period known as the Triassic. Moving up through the layers, dinosaurs evolved into many forms during the Jurassic and dominated the Earth until the end of a period called the Cretaceous. Many species of primitive mammals also evolved alongside dinosaurs at this time, but no apes and not a single human fossil has ever been confirmed in rock layers nearly as old as the Cretaceous. Throughout the history of life, five major extinction events can be clearly seen in the fossil record. These are time periods where almost all life forms abruptly disappear, leaving only a few surviving groups to evolve and repopulate the planet. One such event is found at the end of the Cretaceous and marks the demise of all non-bird dinosaurs. Changing sea levels and intense volcanic activity seem to have weakened dinosaur populations leading up to the extinction, and then catastrophe. At the top of the Cretaceous is a distinct line known as the KPG boundary. Chemical analysis suggests that one or more massive space rocks struck the Earth at this time, producing a global dust cloud that devastated life on our planet. Recently, the discovery of a 110-mile-wide crater, now buried under sediments in Mexico's Yucatan Peninsula, confirms this idea and tells us that the comet or asteroid could have been over 6 miles in diameter. While a few dinosaur populations may have survived a short while after, it was only groups of smaller animals that managed to hang on long enough to repopulate the Earth. Among the mammals that survived, one group eventually gave rise to apes, and finally, in a set of rock layers known as the Pleistocene, fossils representing modern humans can be found. So to sum things up, did dinosaurs ever live alongside humans? While it is hypothetically possible, all verifiable evidence that we know of tells us that the answer is no. With the exception of birds, the dinosaurs died out in a catastrophe near the end of the Cretaceous. According to radiometric dating, the time gap between the extinction of the dinosaurs and the evolution of modern humans is nearly 66 million years. I'm John Perry, and that's what we currently know about the extinction of the dinosaurs, stated clearly. This animation was partly based on two of Dr. Darren Naish's books, Dinosaurs, How They Lived and Evolved, and Hunting Monsters, both of which I highly recommend. If you'd like to see more about the claims of humans living alongside dinosaurs, check out our video on the discovery of soft tissue found inside dinosaur bones. I also recommend the work of fellow YouTuber, Trey the Explainer.
Hello there guys, Trey the Explainer here. On my channel, you can learn about the many corpses people have mistaken for dinosaurs and plesiosaurs and other monsters, impressions once claimed to be human footprints among dino tracks, a proposed stegosaurus carving in an ancient Cambodian temple, and other fascinating claims.
This animation was paid for by our viewers. If you'd like to see more, consider supporting us at patreon.com/statedclearly. So long for now, stay curious.